Today's Hindu editorial that I am going to say is two speeches. India must be mindful of the Pakistan strategy of raising bilateral issues in global fora. The speeches at the UN General Assembly by Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan and a day later by Prime Minister Narendra Modi were studied. In contrast, Mr. Modi focused on India's own role on the world stage and on stage and need to reform the UN and expand the Security Council to give India more representation. Mr. Khan focused less time on Pakistan launch in the broadside against India. Mr. Modi made no reference to Pakistan and spoke about terrorism by in border terms. A reply to Mr. Khan's speech was left to an Indian diplomat who described it as an incessant rant and lies, misinformation and warmongering. Mr. Khan references to India which formed more than a third of his texts repeated the vilification of his previous speeches, accusing the Modi's government of state sponsorship of Islamophobia, of following an extremist ideology of the RSS, which he claims is inspired by Nazi concepts of the racial purity and the supremacy, and of planning a cleanness in the country of minorities. Extreme comparisons were made between the Citizenship Amendment Act and the number bag laws, as well as between the detention camps in Assam and the concentration camps at Nazi Germany. Next, he launched into a diatribe of Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir, more or less mirroring his speech of last year, which included accusations that the government moves off dilute Article 370 and recognize J&K state into union territories were akin to a final solution of genocide, further state and contravenes UN laws. He concluded with reference of low tensions, which were ceasefire violations, have risen, ending of an exaggerated note that referred to Kashmir as a nuclear flashpoint. Mr. Khan's speech can be easily countered, and he is missed at the government. Government has Pakistan's own record on minorities, including its own laws that has been prevent minorities from holding high office, completely demolishing Pakistan credentials to attack India, which is continuously declares secular democracy. And this is our today's editorial. Thank you.